Oh, hey, did you finally decide what to play?
Well, since you were no help, I went ahead and decided to build my own deck, and, oh, by the way, I'm borrowing your Brilliant Fusion Engine.
Oh, yeah, you can borrow that, I don't care, but what deck did you decide on?
Chainburn.
Trick Stars?
No, just Chainburn.
Okay, what?
I'm just kidding, it's ABCs, but seriously, you could play Brilliant Fusion in anything. It really needs to be banned.
Well, actually, not necessarily, because...
Hey, I can do that too, you know! No, I can't.
Started with this video, I actually have some really, really incredible news, exciting news for you guys. So my Discord server actually recently just passed 300 followers on there, so 300 people, 300 of you guys are on my Discord server now, which is just fantastic, and I have to give a huge, huge, huge shout out to Ryan. He's the guy that runs my Discord server for me, helps me run it and everything. He is just fantastic. He's an amazing guy. He does a really, really great job on my Discord server, you know, being a moderator and all that stuff, and, you know, we were talking, and he's been trying to talk me into doing some sort of tournament and stuff, but he didn't want to do just any tournament. He wanted to have, like, this prize and everything, so, like, 200, I can't remember what came up when the server passed 200 people, 200 members, but when 250 came around, I received a mat from MetaMats, okay, and it's a perfect prize, but I wasn't able due to some reasons, I wasn't able to give the mat away yet, but now, in this point in time, and now that the server has passed 300 people, we are going to be doing a huge tournament, and it's going to be amazing, okay? We're going to be doing a tournament on my Discord server, and the prize, guys, is this one-of-a-kind meta mat, okay? You're going to be like, well, that's not one-of-a-kind. This is just a Spirit of the Warrior mat, right? You've shown this on your channel before, and you are right. I have shown this on my channel before, but this is a special prototype where you can customize the color on the back, okay? This has a blue back on it instead of, like, the white back that literally everyone does, and I actually don't know when it's going to be available for purchase. It will be available in the future. MetaMats didn't give me an exact, you know, date or anything like that, but as of right now, and currently, this is a one-of-a-kind Spirit of the Warrior MetaMats playmat, and I think that is a perfect prize for first place in the YugiNoNo Discord tournament. So, if you guys want to enter into that tournament, then be sure to follow my Discord, you know, join my Discord. The link to that is down in the description. There's a tournament thread on there and stuff, and Ryan, also known as Enrated Sevenfold, will be happy to help you with everything. Once again, the link to my Discord is down in the description. If you want to compete and have a chance to win this amazing one-of-a-kind cloth playmat, then be sure to enter to win, and good luck to everyone that enters. I hope that you do really, really well. It's just going to be modern format and cards released up until this date. It's not anything special like a GOAT tournament of 2002 or anything like that. It's nothing, you know, too complicated. It's just pretty straightforward, modern format tournament. You get a badass mat if you win it. Straightforward. But now moving on with this discussion, okay? Obviously, we're going to be talking about Brilliant Fusion, and I mentioned Brilliant Fusion the other day when I was talking about, Yu-Gi-Oh! After the ban list, okay? That was the video I made the other day, and, just so you guys know, I made that video on Sunday. It's not going to interfere with Old School Sundays in the future. I only released that video on Sunday because I was really sick and I was having to play catch-up, and I wanted to make another video after my initial reaction to the ban list, and that was the video I made, and I just released it on Sunday when I felt better. So in the future, the Old School Sunday is like, you know, showing, old duels, you know, or, past formats or just anything like that. That should be continuing. As a matter of fact, introduction to Dragon Roller format video, you guys like my introduction videos, you know, I did an introduction to 2002 format, GOAT format, Necroz format. The introduction to Dragon Roller format is on my to-do list, guys, and I can't wait to do that, but I have to, refresh my memory on some things and stuff because I haven't played Dragon Roller format literally since Dragon Roller format, so I have to refresh my memory and stuff so that when I make that video, I'm not completely wrong about everything. But now, seriously, moving on with the actual discussion here, okay? Like I was saying the other day, I mentioned, me thinking initially that Brilliant Fusion was in danger. I felt like, you know, after seeing, Grinder Golem and Gofu and just, you know, and Love Weeder and stuff, just go away, essentially, on this new list, I was sitting there thinking, like, well, that literally leaves Brilliant Fusion as, like, pretty much the only really good generic engine left. I mean, we don't have the Speedroid engine, for example, anymore because, you know, they put Terra Top to one. We still have one tour guide for the tour guide engine, the, Perform Age engine, even though, you know, Juggler is back at one. It's not full power. It's not, you know, full power like, you know, in Pepe Magicians, for example. It's not anything like that. So in other words, what I'm getting out here is as far as generic engines that could be splashed into a plethora of different decks goes, Brilliant Fusion is pretty much all that there is left. left. It's all you have left. And that is actually where my concern lies. Does not mean that Brilliant Fusion is in some sort of danger on the next list if it gets busted wide open in this format. And honestly, for a lot of decks, I mean, it's getting to the point where I almost don't care what deck you're playing. Brilliant Fusion raises the ceiling and raises like your starting power of any deck you put it in just about. It's just, it's incredible, guys. Brilliant Fusion is a fantastic card, and that is why I feel like it is at risk, because just, you know, off the top of my head here, I know I do this a lot. I've been seriously thinking about splashing Brilliant Fusion in my Pendulum deck, because if you send Lazuli, you know, in like Master Pendulum, you get the Master Pendulum to your hand, and you get two normal summons. Once again, that is just off the top of my head, because I was thinking about it yesterday, you know, thinking about building this deck yesterday, you know, and messing around with that kind of strategy, but, and I haven't really done it yet. I don't even know if it's going to be good, but the point still remains. You can do a lot of really interesting things and raise the ceiling of a lot of decks with Brilliant Fusion, including my Herald deck, okay? Because you guys have seen my Herald deck. You guys have seen the turn one unbeatable board, I mean, that it can make. I mean, unless you have Spear Mode, okay? I mean, insert the meme here if you have Spear Mode, okay? But you know, outside of that, Herald really makes a turn one unbeatable board, because you end with 5 or 6 negates in hand and 2 Heralds on the board, so even if they Kaiju you, you know, you don't care because you still have another Herald, and Herald's not like, you know, once per chain or anything. And also, you have Ouroboros, which takes a card away from your opponent, which means they start with 5 cards instead of 6 when they go second, and that really screws them over. So in other words, you have 5 or 6 negates in hand, and they only start with 5 cards. You can negate any, like, every card in their hand. It's just really, really bad. And those are just 2 things that I have come up with. We all remember, you know, Brilliant ABC. We have seen, you know, World Chalice and stuff like that, you know, play Brilliant Fusion. I mean, and there are several other decks out there that can play Brilliant Fusion and play it very, very well and make really, really good boards. And that's where the concern really lies. Not only is it like just this, you know, standalone generic splashable engine now, and basically the only one left, really. Not only that, but with this new list, it's very, very apparent that Konami is trying to fix some of the problems that they have started with Link summoning. Namely, you know, you being able to use any 2 monsters to make Link monsters. I mean, it was a really good idea, and it's really, really fun, don't get me wrong. But you can see how if they would have kept everything archetype specific when it comes to Links, we wouldn't be having as much of a problem with our metagame right now. So all that being said about Brilliant Fusion being able to raise the ceiling of, you know, basically any deck that it's put into, And on top of that, giving you 2 normal summons through Seraphonite, does that put the Brilliant Engine, more specifically, I should have done this earlier, but more specifically, does that put Seraphonite at risk of getting banned? Obviously not immediately right now, because we literally just got a list, but I'm talking about in the future. Let's just say this format evolves into just about everybody playing Brilliant Fusion to kind of, you know, raise their cap and stuff like I was talking about, and being able to, you know, make bigger first turn boards and combo more and stuff, not to mention, you know, that second normal summon. I mean, do not underestimate that second normal summon, guys. It is so good. But with all that being said, especially after this new list with other things being limited, you know, and Gofu just being banned, for example, how powerful does that make Brilliant? Does this new list push Brilliant Fusion to the point to where everyone's going to basically have to start running it to increase the speed of their deck and their turn one boards? And my answer to that is not necessarily. And the reason why is because looking at this list, I kind of missed this, you know, upon first glance and stuff, especially because I was really sick last week. So when the list first dropped, I was medicated and stuff. But the more I looked at the list and the more I thought about it, I was like, I don't think Seraphonite or, you know, just the Brilliant Engine, I don't think that it's going to be hurt at all, at least not yet. I mean, especially because, you know, like I was saying a minute ago, we have to see, you know, what kind of forms from this new list, you know, from this format, like how we're gonna have to wait and see how everything, you know, takes hold, you know, takes shape and everything. Basically what I've been saying the past couple of videos, but just looking at the list and the card pool and the meta cards that have been being played and stuff, I don't think that Brilliant Fusion is in really any danger, and I think that it's a completely fair card, at least in this moment in time. And the main reason why I feel that way is because Ash Blossom is a card, guys. And I know a lot of people use the excuse all the time, like, you know, well, this card's a card, so therefore, you know, this could be legal. Well, I'm not going to use that just with Ash Blossom. I have other suggestions as well. I'm just going to open up with Ash Blossom, okay? Because Ash Blossom is like this really, it's like the best hand trap we've ever had, okay? And it's, I'm fearing the day that we get something way more broken than Ash Blossom. I mean, it's inevitable, it's gonna happen, but the point is, Ash Blossom immediately, and I mean literally immediately, stops Brilliant Fusion, and I mean, it's still a one for one, but now your opponent still has that Garnet in their deck, or, you know, that Lazuli, or whatever their, you know, one target, or maybe they're playing two, I don't know. Either way, they still have those targets for Brilliant Fusion in the deck, and that's gonna be my first point about why Brilliant Fusion is completely fair, is because Ash Blossom, everyone's really playing Ash Blossom. Anyone, you know, that plays competitively right now is playing Ash Blossom. So since that is the case, the chances of you resolving Brilliant Fusion go down drastically. And my second reason is gonna be just kind of a cop-out, more or less, but I got a cool thing to add to it. My second reason is that there's just a lot of cards, just in general in Yu-Gi-Oh, that can stop Brilliant Fusion. I mean, just off the top of my head, I mean, Solemn Warning, the new Counter Fairies, you know, Counter Fairy deck is out. People were playing that. It's a really good deck. Then they got not only do they have Solemn Warning, but they got Judgment back too, okay? Like, there are cards in Yu-Gi-Oh that completely, you know, just completely stop Brilliant Fusion in its tracks. Not to mention, what's the card's name? A Dark Designator, okay? Something that, you know, someone that a fan showed me at the last regionals I was at in Louisiana, the Shreveport regionals. He was playing the pink deck. I can't remember his name off the top of my head right now, but he was playing, like, this spell card called Dark Designator, which means, you know, which says that essentially that you name a card in your opponent's deck, and your opponent adds that card to their hand if they have it, you know? If you know what their Brilliant target is, you can get their Garnet. It's typically Garnet. You can get their Garnet out of their deck and into their hand, instantly bricking their Brilliant Fusion if you go first before them. So between, you know, setting traps and stuff and hand traps and just having, you know, really clever text like that, you could see how, you know, if everyone started playing Brilliant Fusion, it's not hard to counter. It would be like, you know, back in Necrod's format when the Xinlock was a thing, everyone started playing, you know, Exiled Force, you know, Dark Hole, Raigeki, you know, just different cards to be able to out the Xinlock. It would be like similar to that. People would, if Brilliant Fusion became that big of a problem, like if it was that strong of a starter that led to a lot of degenerate things, then people would come up with clever solutions just like in Necrod's format to be able to get rid of it. But reason number three, and this is the most important reason, guys, it is a very high risk, high reward engine. In other words, high reward meaning that if you draw the thing, like just the Brilliant Fusion, and you draw it with, like, you know, other extenders in your hand, you're most likely, if your opponent doesn't have any disruption that really screws you anyways, you're most likely going to be able to build a really good turn one board that your opponent's going to have a really hard time to get over. But it is high risk, because if you draw multiple Brilliant Fusions or just that Garnet, then you have dead cards in your hand, which usually means you effectively immediately lose. I can tell you right now, every single duel just about that I have lost with my Herald deck, it is because I drew two Brilliants and a Garnet, or a Brilliant and a Garnet, or something, you know, some combination like that. Same thing with Cyber Dragons. Most of the duels that I've lost with Cyber Dragons, either, you know, well, Cyber Dragons is a little different because it's an old, you know, really, really old deck with not, you know, as high of a ceiling. So, you know, when I'm playing my combo Cyber Dragons and stuff, I either lose because I draw, you know, Garnet, or I lose because, you know, just everything else is just kind of better. It's not that the deck doesn't do its job, it just is, everything else is just kind of better. Cyber Dragons need more support. And hopefully we're getting it in Cybernetic Horizon, but that is neither here nor there. What I'm saying, guys, is that high risk, high reward means that you're not necessarily going to win just because you're playing the really powerful Brilliant engine. It means that you're, in a lot of cases, going to lose because you're playing the cards that you're playing, which is something very, very interesting in Yu-Gi-Oh! That doesn't really happen very often. I mean, the first instance of it, maybe, was it the first instance? No, I guess it would be the second. I can't remember. But, I mean, like, it's very similar to, like, Speedroid at Terror Top, okay? You don't want to draw the Takatan board. You didn't want to draw that thing. It's very similar to that. You know, more recently, before Maxi got banned, Maxi, when it was at one, you didn't want to have it. You didn't want to draw it as your sixth card. You always, you know, or you didn't want to draw it later in the duel. You wanted to have it in your opening five cards every time. And if you didn't have it in your opening five cards, it was just kind of an okay card, a dead card. It was really, like, Maxi is really good, like, going seconds if your opponent, like, has a Gamma or something like that, so you can chain a Maxi and be able to draw and kind of dig and be able to try to play through that Gamma, you know, that they just activated. But it's the same thing. It's the exact same concept. It's high reward because if you draw the Maxi in your opening hands, it's really, really good because everyone and their dog special summons. But it is also high risk because if you draw it, like, let's just say as your sixth card, what does it really do for you? You would really rather that card be some sort of extender so you could try to push, or, you know, or you'd rather that card be like a kaiju or something so you could try to get over something. You just name, insert example here, okay? You can see like how it's high risk to be drawing that maxi, you know, later in the duel. And that is really why Brilliant Fusion, in my opinion, is completely, completely fair. It's because you can lose from your own cards. And technically, now that I think about it, there's a fourth reason why Brilliant Fusion is completely fair. And it's because we only have one extra deck zone now. And since we only have one extra deck zone now, sometimes it's a little awkward with that Seraphinite in the extra deck zone to get it off the field so you can make a, you know, so you can make another Xyz monster or something like that. In other words, sometimes it's a little awkward to get that thing gone so you can make a Link monster. I don't know how else to really explain it. I'm just gonna point out that it's just kind of awkward in the extra deck zone sometimes, really depending on what deck you play and stuff. I'm really referring to Cyber Dragons and Extreme Rogue here, you know, just I've had, you know, problems with Brilliant Fusion and Cyber Dragons before, but it's just like such a necessary evil that you have to play it because Cyber Dragons need more support. But anyways, guys, I know I don't explain everything absolutely perfect every single time, but I really appreciate you guys watching. I appreciate all of you guys, you know, that like my Facebook page. Oh, and I have a Twitter account now, so if you guys want to follow me on Twitter, the link to that is also down in the description. Thank you all of you guys on my Discord server. Shout out to everyone on my Discord server. Once again, if you guys want a chance to win an amazing playmat, then be sure to check out my Discord server and stuff. And good luck to everyone that enters. Seriously, I wish you all really, really good luck. And all of my other links are down in the description as well. I mean, literally everything is down in the description, including my Patreon, guys. And shout out to all of my patrons. You know, shout out to all of my Discord people. Shout out to everybody. You guys are just so amazing. I have the best fans on the planet. I really, truly do. Thank you all so much for watching. And until next time, be sure to dick slap that like button and subscribe. Subscribe.